Hey guys, this is Mike from Mike Stickers. In this video, I'm going to show y'all what settings I use on my label printer whenever I'm getting ready to actually print. So I had someone ask me in my YouTube comments about what settings I use. So this is where I'm going to show you. I use the Epson C6500AU, and it's a dedicated label printer. It's all it's used for. I'm going to show you the settings I use in CorelDraw and Silhouette Studio. And then also on the machine itself. So I'm gonna go over the setup and then also the print settings. So stay tuned to find out what I use.
Okay, so first thing you wanna do is go to Silhouette Studio. I just have the basic edition. I don't have the business edition, so I can't export into different type of file types. If I create the file within this edition, this is the only place that I can work with it or print it from. So I need to open it up here because I can't do it in CorelDraw. So I'm going to go to Merge. Okay, I'm going to do these ones here. Now it defaults to the page size it normally is. You go up here to the right, top right corner there. You can change the size of the page. It's set up to auto right here to what it's supposed to be for this machine. I'm going to change it to 1.5 width, 1.5 height, and then I want to get rid of this red line because that's just within Silhouette Studio. I don't actually need, I just want to get rid of it as a visual. I have it set up upside down because that's how I want it to print, but if I wanted to, I could change that in the print settings. I'm going to go up here and go to print now, and by the way, if it wasn't on the center of the page, you can click on this. Click on the image and then click on this right here. It looks like a crosshair in the middle of the page. That'll center it up within the middle of the page. And you can go to print. And you see it's not showing an accurate representation. It's still set up for the last time you print, you know, that I printed with a different page size. So this is kind of like a glitch or a mess up within Silhouette Studio, in my opinion. What you have to do is you have to go in here, go to the printer that you're gonna actually print from, which is my Epson ColorWorks C6500. I'm gonna go to preferences. They have presets within here that you can make. I have a whole bunch of presets that have all my different labels that I print from. To create those, you go into media definitions, you go to new, you label, you put a name for it, and then you set up whatever settings you want, and then save that, and then it'll have it in here for you. So I already have, right now it's at custom. I'm gonna go and put it on 1.5 inch circles. It's gonna ask me if I wanna change the settings. I say yes. And then everything's how I want it. You can go in here if you wanted to tweak it and do, once you have a custom setting, or sorry, a preset, you can actually go in and just tweak individual parts of it by clicking on custom. And then now you can go in and change if you wanted to do a different spot color, color correction within there, spot color correction, you do that there. You can change the print quality, you can change what kind of paper it is, but I have it how I want it now, so I'm going to click OK. And then if you also, sorry, let me show you something else. If you wanted to print upside down, you can go into here and click Rotate 180. If you wanted to click it in landscape, you can do this. You can see on the representation over here it changes. So 180 or regular, I want it regular now because I already flipped it in the design software. I already have it flipped, so I'm going to click OK. I'm going to click apply, okay, because if you print it right now, it's going to print just like it's going to be messed up, okay. You click apply, and now this is the workaround for the glitch in Silhouette Studio. You X out of here, okay. You click cancel. Now you just immediately go back in and go to print. Now you can see it's showing an accurate representation. You go to press print, and everything will be set the way you want it. You can click on preferences just to double check and make sure nothing changed, but it should all be the same. And then now you can set the quantity that you want to print. I'm going to put it to 3. Click. I don't have to click apply. You can go straight to print if you want to. And then print them out and see how they come out. See if the margins are correct or if you need to make adjustments. Okay, all my margins are correct, so I can go ahead and print all of them now. I'm gonna go ahead and go back in there. I need 500 of these, but I always print extra. I'm gonna go and do 520. When you apply the labels onto the core, you have to stick a piece of tape or something on there to hold it on the core, so that messes up at least one label. And then when you close off the whole entire roll after printing them, you have to mess up basically two labels because you put another piece of tape across those two labels to seal it off. So you always want to print extra, and I print more extra than what I need to, just in case some of them mess up. Okay, so in CorelDraw is basically the same thing. You're going to go ahead and open up CorelDraw. I have it set to a normal sheet that I print from my stickers, which is 18 by 24, but I'm going to change that in a minute. I'm going to import the file first. I'll work with a different one here that I can actually use within this program. All right, so same thing. I'm going to have to change the size. I have this set up for my die cut stickers. So I have my print bleed, and I've got my cut line within there. I'll go ahead and take those out just for the point, just to show you for this. Need to add that back. Okay. So I'm going to combine all of this real quick. You shouldn't have to necessarily do all this right away. All right, so I have one image. It's at 3 inches right now. I want to be 1.5. You see it changed both directions because I have the lock key. If I didn't have that, it would only change one. It would look all funky. So it would have been like that. So make sure that you have it locked when you do it, or you'll need to change both sides. So you can change them both to 1.5. I'm gonna go ahead and put the lock on now. Now you got that 1.5, you need to change your page to 1.5 by 1.5. You can click on the image and press P on the keyboard, and it'll center it in the center of the page. Now, when you go to print, you're going to want to change to whatever printer that you're trying to use. For me, it's the Epson ColorWorks C6500AU. You go into the preferences, and I have my presets. You're going to change it. So right now, it's set up to 4.25 by 6. You're going to want to change it to a 1.5-inch circle. If you don't already have that set up, I guess it's noticing that I'm already printing from another program, I guess. If you don't already have your preset set up, you can go into media definitions here. You can go click new and then create a preset. If you need to adjust that preset, you can click on custom, and then it goes in here and lets you change the different parameters of it. You can change it to higher quality, medium quality, normal quality. Click OK. You can then click apply, but I'm already printing from another program right now, so I can't actually do it. But you can click apply or press print. You don't need to click apply. I'm sorry, you just press print once you have your quantity set that you want. That's how I do it from here. If there's actual settings for, I think that if you go into, I think that's all that I use from here. So if you print from, a certain program like Adobe Illustrator, and it gives you the option to fit to page or print actual size, then you want to fit it to the page. Okay, you want to fit to page, but with my settings, I don't ever see that with the programs I use. I think it just knows that I want it to fit to the page. So that's that. Then you can print your quantities from here. You shouldn't have any problems. The only other thing that you would ever need to do from the machine really is adjust the margins from there, but that's pretty much it. If y'all have any questions, please let me know. All right, guys, this is super hard to point out, but I need y'all to see this. So there's a there's an alignment adjustment that you have to make. I don't even know what you call it. I can't think of the name for it. But it's the gap sensor. That's what it's called. So if you look right here, this gray piece, there's a circle right in the middle, and then there's a dash on either side. That circle represents the middle of this gap sensor, and you have to move this to so that it's in the center of the label. Now, on the little bitty 1.5 inch ones, it almost has to be on the outside. It doesn't really like to be right in the center, but I find that this is the right setting for it. I just kind of know where it needs to be. So you can push in on this with a pin. It's not easy to do, but you push in on it a little bit and then can move it left or right. And that's how you move it. But then there's not just that one though. There's one on the bottom also. There's one down below that. There's one, it's hard to see on camera, but it's right down in there. What you have to do is you actually have to take this out, take the roll out, set it to the side. There's a blue handle here. You pull on that. This whole entire thing goes down. Now, you can see it right there. There's the sensor. And the sensor is actually down in this, down here. But that's the alignment adjustment. You move that so that it's in the same spot. There's little dashes and hash marks right next to it, and you just match it up with the same mark that's over here on this one. And then once you have it in place, you close it, and then those two marks should line up once you have them together there. Then you can put your paper roll back in, or your label roll back in, and then feed everything. And then I'll show you what to do after that. One more thing to note here is that your pincher, your media pincher here, whatever you'd call it, the media guide, needs to be pushed all the way against it. So when I first got this machine also, I had trouble figuring out how to feed the machine or feed the paper through there, feed the roll through there. I wasn't really sure how to do it. So this is the clamp. You put that down first. This is kind of like a little sensor. I think when you push that down when loading the paper, it kind of triggers it and knows to start looking for it. What you do is you start feeding it through. You lay it flat on there and start pushing it down through there. There's a guide right there in the front that it has to go under. And when it does, it'll grab it. It'll grab it and it'll pull it forward in there a little bit. And then you'll hear the machine make some noise. You just want to double check that this pincher here, or this guide, is all the way snug against it. Because sometimes it'll look close, but it won't be all the way against it. It needs to be so that you get perfect print margins. Alright, so now that you have that, you can just shut it. Let's see here. And it's going to say paused once you turn it back, once you close the cover. You can see that it's on gap detection. If it wasn't on gap detection, then you would go in here and change the type of media detection, but it is gap detection. So now you can go ahead and unpause it. I'm about to show y'all something that most people don't know how to do. So watch this next step. All right, it's gonna feed out a little bit. Yeah, you can tell it didn't even feed out. It's the alignment there is going to be off on the cut alignment for sure. But what you want to do is go ahead and go in here, go to menu. Sorry, hang on. We're going to go back to this one. We're going to go to print position adjustment. And I want to make sure everything's zeroed out. So I had already had adjustments before, but I want to zero these out. Oops. So this guy, I want to get back down to zero. Sorry, I know some of this could be hard to see. That doesn't really help. Well, I don't know if you can see the screen on there. I'm having trouble seeing it on my preview screen. But I'm putting it down to zero. in the top position. I'm gonna put it down, we'll put it at zero. And then over here, I'm gonna go back to home, I'm gonna go to menu, I'm gonna go to maintenance, I'm gonna go down to calibration, I'm gonna go to media detect. It's gonna run media detect. Watch what it does here. It's gonna move around the paper and figure out where the gaps are based upon what the sensor sees. Calibration and process. Okay, it did it. Now the thing I think might be off is my cut setting. Let's see where it cuts it at. No, I'm happy with that. All right, so now I'm ready to print off a few and see if the print margins look good.
All right, so I don't really think I've shown y'all much about my rewinder here. The roll, the core goes on there like that. Right now I have it set up for 2.5 inch width. I'm gonna have to adjust that. So these two different plates here, and they shift and expand these fingers right here. So you expand it all the way and hold tension on it. And then these are like cam locks here, like kind of like what you have on a bicycle for your tires. There's three different ones, and as you turn them, it increases the pressure on the fingers, spreads them even more. And you get the proper tension to where it's gonna hold it on there. Now I have different sections or different areas on this, different lines on this table. I've drilled holes so that it holds the rewinder down. I adjust it whenever I go to a different width of a label. Right now I have it for 2.5 inch circles. Now I have to put it at 1.5 inch. I'll move it over to that line. Now it's gonna line up perfectly when it comes out of the machine, because the labels come out of the left side of this machine here. So you don't wanna tighten it too much, because it's gonna bend that plate. There's a screw on each side so it doesn't rock this thing back and forth, and so it holds it in a perfect straight line. All right, now I don't know that I have this set up correctly. This is the way I've always done it. I couldn't find any real directions of how to do it. I don't know if I'm doing it right, but this is what works for me. Okay, I'm gonna print out a few to test it out. Okay, and the margins are off. I definitely need to adjust that some. So pretty much probably where I had it before is gonna be good. I was told that you should always zero out the margins before you do the calibration, but it seems like I pretty much always have to put it back in the same spot anyways. So I'm gonna put it in -1 on the top position, and I'm gonna go -0.5 on the left position. Sorry, not negative, I'm gonna be positive. 0.5. All right, let me see where that comes out. I'm gonna need to get at least 10 or 15 printed out before I'm gonna be able to attach it to the core here. So that's getting closer, but I still need to bring it down some. It looks like it's centered up pretty good. I still need to bring it down a little bit more. I'm gonna go another 0.5. So 1.5. Let's see what that looks like. Thank you. here. That looks pretty good. I'm gonna go a little bit more.
I'm gonna go to 1.8 and see what that looks like. I probably need to go to 2. Okay, so just a little bit more, yeah. I'm gonna go to 2.0. Oh, that's at 1. I actually put it at 1.9 already, so I'm gonna go to 2.1. See what that looks like. You can see I've already got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 printed out, and I still don't have the margins perfect. Okay, so I think it's pretty good there. You see I printed out 14 or 15 of them before I got the margins just correct. So it takes a little bit of time to get that just right. I'm gonna leave some of these on there, but not all of them. Some of them are good enough, but not all of them. I always print some extras anyways. So I'm gonna tear off right here, okay? Now I'm gonna feed that underneath this bar. I don't know if that's how you're supposed to do this, but that's the way I've always done it. I'm gonna print a few more, or I'm just gonna get the print going, and then I can attach it. I'm gonna use a blank label to attach it to the core. So I'll have that ready right there. Now I can attach it over here. I want this guide to be all the way against it as much as possible without completely touching it. Then I can turn on the rewinder. With the 1.5, I don't put it on full speed because it doesn't need it. It'll jerk it too hard. Going to rock the table back and forth as it does this just because of the print head movement. It's got the tension on it.
And that's really everything. If there's anything else you can think of that I missed, just let me know and I'll respond back to you. The only other thing I can think of right now is that I believe the person who's asking me questions about all these settings said they're going to do an external roll coming from behind the machine. And if so, on the media settings, you just go ahead and change to external roll instead of internal roll. That way that you have to do that for it to work. Otherwise, it'll think that it's out of paper. So you just take the whole roll out of the inside of the machine and just leave it out. And then just run the paper through the gap in the backside. You can still close the lid and run the paper through the backside. So just make sure to change the settings within the media settings. So anyways, anything else, y'all, just let me know. All right, y'all take it easy. Thanks for watching, sharing, subscribing, all the comments. I really appreciate everything.